photo tip for the day, composition. Okay. Very important. This is something that most people do not do when they're composing a shot, and it's going to correct problems. Okay, composition in a nutshell. There's going to be one thing, not several, that will draw your eye into the picture, like it's a painting. And so what you want to do is define that one point. Like, for example, it could be this courthouse behind me. It could be this fountain. But there's going to be something that engages you and pulls your eye in. So that's what you're thinking. Now, a lot of times the mistake people make is picking several things that are the point of interest so that your eye goes, what do I look at? What do I look at? I don't know where to go, up and down, and you get dizzy and you stop looking. Or the point of interest they have chosen is so far away in the distance, they have to have a 10-minute explanation to describe to you what is the point of interest. Okay, so the picture failed. Because if you're making the point of interest, this person far away behind me, where's the person? Like, say, down there, somebody walking by. I'm sorry if you're dizzy. Picking somebody way far away and making the picture all about them, and it's just a tiny dot in your composition. No, doesn't work, ever. Has never worked in the history of photography. Okay, so once you pick your point of focus, another mistake people make is they don't look at every single side of their picture, up, down, right, left. You might move it so it includes more. Even just a tiny bit is going to give you a totally different picture. Okay, so there's that. And you might have to crouch down low, get up high, try a different angle. But continuing on with composition, you're going to start with something that really catches your eye. And then you're going to frame it. And think of yourself like a painter in a hurry. And then you won't be in such a hurry. You can't just click, click, click. You have to have some thought to it. And don't think you're gonna fix it in Photoshop. Yeah, right. That takes hours. How about if you just get it right in the moment and not have to fix it in Photoshop? I know how to use Photoshop, but I don't use it anymore because I don't need to, and you don't need to either. If you take the picture, I learned how to use it when I was converting film to digital files, high resolution digital files for my exhibitions that were sponsored by, thank you, Jungle Digital, one woman exhibitions, several. And what I want to tell you is you can do it in camera. You don't have to think I'm going to correct this later, because you'll be on the computer a long time trying to correct stuff. Anyway, composition. That's where it starts. And you can get a much better composition by being thoughtful about the edges of your picture, picking that point of interest that draws your eyes. Like, you can't look away from it. That's how good it has to be. You can easily look away from somebody way off in the distance that you can hardly see, which needs a long explanation as to why this picture is important because of this person you can't see in it, okay? So get closer than you think if you're gonna do a person as part of a picture, or if you're just gonna have them in an environmental kind of picture to show size or something, that's okay. But if it's gonna be your main point of interest, then you need to be closer so people can see that and be in rapture because of it. You want people to really look at your picture, but first of all, you have to be entertained, amused, and have a compelling moment with your composition. And you'll be surprised at what you can get. I know you can do it. So, questions. And by the way, I have two spots for Rome Photography Adventure in January, Rome, Italy, only 4 people, and the 2 going are wonderful. So let me know if you want to know information about that. I can help you with accommodation and ideas about flights and everything. So I'll see you in the next video. Enjoy and keep on photographing.